Jamuna te Ravanachari. Jamuna te Ravanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivardhari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivardhari. Yasoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Yasoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana. Jamuna tera vanachari. Jamuna tera vanachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Radha Madhava, Jaya Radha Madhava, Radha Madhava, Jaya Radha Madhava. Jaya Gaura Nitai, Jaya Gaura Nitai. Gaura Nitai, Jaya Gaura Nitai. Jaya Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram. Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Jang Vishnupad Paramahamsa Paribrajakacharya Astottara Sata Sishimat Abhay Charanar Vinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki ISKCON Bhavati Founder Acharya Divine Grace La Prabhupada Ki Sisri Radha Madhava Vasta Sakya Vrinda Sriman Mahaprabhu Ki Sisri Krishna Balarama Ki Sisri Pancha Tattva Bhagavan Ki Sisri Singhadev Prahlad Maharaj Ki Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Balarama Jayanti Mahamahotsav Ki Samabhita Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Ki Nitai Gaura Premanande All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories, all glories, all glories to Guru and Gauranga. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshu Sunmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamaiham Dadati Sa Padantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Juta Padakamalam Sri Gurum Vaishnavamsa Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sādvaitaṁ sābadhūtaṁ parijana sahitaṁ Krishna chaitanya devaṁ Śrī Rādhā Krishna pādaṁ sahagana lalitā śrī viśākhānitāṁśca Namoṁ Viṣṇu pādāya Krishna prasthāya bhūtale śrīmate bhakti vedānta swāminiti nāmine Namaste Sarasate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunnavadi Paschata Desatarine Bancha Kalpataru Bhasya Kripasindu Bhayevasya Patitanang Pavanebho Vaishnavibho Namo Namaha Namo Mahavadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurutishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindha Dinabandha Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Taptakanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrinda Vaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Haripriye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudiraye Nasta prayasu avadreshu Nityang bhagavata sevaya Bhagavati uttama sloke Bhaktir bhavati nashtaki On the occasion of Balarama Jayanti Today we will be reading from a special verse from 10th canto 10th canto, chapter 2, text number 13. And the chapter is entitled Prayers by the Demigods. Garbha Sankarsanatam Vai Prahu Sankarsanam Bhuvi Rameti Lokaramana Balabhadram Balasaya garba sankarsana tambai prahu sankarsanam bhuvi rameti lokaramana balabhadram balasraya garba sankarsana tambai prahu sankarsanam bhuvi rameti lokaramana balabhadram balasraya Matajis. Garbha Sankarsanat, because he'll be taken from the womb of Devakī to that of Rohiṇī. Tam him, Rohiṇī Nandan, the son of Rohiṇī. Bai, indeed. Prahu, people will call. Sankarsanam, by the name Sankarsan. Bhuvi, in the world. Rama iti, he will also be called Rama. Loka Ramanat, because of his special mercy in enabling people in general to become devotees. Balabhadram, he will also be called Balabhadra. Bala Usrayat, because of extensive bodily strength. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, S. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. The son of Rohiṇī will also be celebrated as Saṅkarṣaṇa because of being sent from the womb of Devakī to the womb of Rohiṇī. He will be called Rāma because of his ability to please all the inhabitants of Gokula. And he will be known as Balabhadra because of his extensive physical strength. Please repeat. The son of Rohiṇī will also be celebrated as Saṅkarṣaṇa because of being sent from the womb of Devakī to the womb of Rohiṇī. He will be called Rāma because of his ability to please all the inhabitants of Gokula. And he will be known as Balabhadra because of his extensive physical strength. Purport. These are some of the reasons why Balaram is known as Saṅkarṣaṇa, Balaram or sometimes Rama. In the Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. People sometimes object when Ram is accepted as Balaram. But although devotees of Lord Ram may object, they should know that there is no difference between Balaram and Lord Ram. Here, Srimad Bhagavatam clearly states that Balaram is also known as Ram, Rameti. Therefore, it is not artificial for us to speak of Lord Balaram as Lord Ram. Jayadev Goswami also speaks of three Rams, Parshuram, Raghupati Ram and Balaram. All of them are Ramas. Mukham karati vachalam pangul langhaita giring jatkripat amaham bande sri guru dinatarinam paramananda madhavam sri chaitanya isharam namo vishnu padaya krishna prasthaya Hare Krishna. Today is a very special day, the appearance day of Lord Balaram, Balaram Jayanti. This is already 8:30. Today is fasting, so depending on your availability, I'll speak. So maybe 9 o'clock is the timeline to finish the class. But today is a special day, and also we started late. So maybe we can go up to 9:15. Is that okay with all of you? Then in that time frame, I'll try to speak. Because Balaram is Ananta, so to glorify him in 45 minutes is very, very difficult. But we are in the material world, we are all limited. So in the same way, you are also limited by time. Although Lord is the controller of time. Let's see how it goes. So here, three names of Balaram have been explained by Srila Prabhupada in the purport. So there was some debate between Prabhupada disciples. So in the Ram, in Mahamantra, which Ram it indicates? So one group is in the opinion it indicates Balaram. There's another group, they're in the opinion that it indicates Raghupati Ram. There's another group that indicates that is Parshuram. So they approach Prabhupada, so which Ram is this? Prabhupada said, all are true, but actually this Ram indicates Krishna. So Ram means who gives pleasure. So Krishna gives pleasure, so therefore Ram indicates Krishna. So that is called Krishna consciousness movement. Everything can be Krishna. That is the expertise of Srila Prabhupada. And actually that is the truth. So Ram also means Krishna. So here three names have been given. So any of the name can be referred while we talk about Ram. But because today is Balaram Day, so we will focus on Lord Balaram. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami explains, and Srila Prabhupada in many lectures has explained, there is no difference between Krishna and Balaram. Both are Supreme Personality of Godhead. Both have 64 qualities. Both of them kill demons. Both of them dance with the gopis. So all are same. But there is two difference. First, there is a difference in color. So Balaram has fair complexion and Krishna has dark complexion. There is a difference. And Krishna is God, Balaram is also God, but there is a difference. When Krishna appears as God, he appears to accept service. But when Balaram appears as God, he appears to serve God. So that's why Balaram is known as servitor Godhead. And that's why he is the original guru, Balaram. Because all the services to Krishna go through Lord Balaram. So Balaram does lot of services to Krishna personally. In Vrindavan, devotees serve in five different rasas: Santa, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya. Neutrality, servitorship, friendship, parental and conjugal. And there are different devotees also render in this process. But Lord Balaram is very unique. He renders service to Krishna in all these five rasas. So that is the difference between other servants of God and Lord Balaram as servant. Because he is very, very expert in serving Krishna. So how he serves in different rasas, that is also explained by different acharyas. So Lord Balaram serves Krishna in Santaras by expanding himself in different paraphernalia of Krishna. So when Krishna wants to blow flute, so flute is Balaram. When he wants to dance with the gopis, Rasasthali is Balaram. When he wants to lie down, taking rest, so Balaram expands himself as Ananta says and becomes his bed. So when that Balaram comes as Lord Nityananda Prabhu, and that time to have Harinam Sankirtan, you need Mridanga. So Mridanga is Balaram. So Krishna cannot perform any pastime without Balaram. And the dham, different dhams are also Balaram. So in this way, different objects of Krishna's pastimes, paraphernalia, are non-different from Balaram. And in that way, Balaram serves Krishna. That is Santaras. Second is Dasaras. So Balaram is elder brother. So how he can be servant? You see different pictures that Krishna massages the feet of Balaram. And there is picture also, Balaram massages the feet of Krishna. So there is a pastime for this also. Why Balaram wanted to become elder brother? So you have to go back. And when Lord Ramchandra was in the forest, so Sita Devi as a wife naturally follows Ram. But generally brothers don't become so much loyal, right? Now it is in Kali Yuga. You cannot imagine that brother in the forest and brother follows him. In Kali Yuga, the brothers fight for the property in the court. So what to talk about Lakshmana's behavior and attitude? Unusual. And what is the unique nature of Lakshmana? In the pastimes of 14 years of Ramchandra's exile, all the brothers were staying with his wife, even Lord Ram. Although he is in the forest, his wife was there. Bharat had his wife with him. Shatrughna also had wife with him. But only Lakshmana was without wife in the forest. That shows the dedication of Lakshmana. So Lakshmana did lot of service. So I'll explain one to explain the mood, and then I'll explain why he wanted to become elder brother. So there is a story of Guha. So Guha arranged Ramchandra some facilities for Ram in the forest. So where Ramchandra will sleep? So Guha proposed, you should lie down on the grass. Grass bed. So when Lakshmana heard that, it was like a thunderbolt in his heart that my dear Lord will sleep on grass. When he heard that, if my Lord has to lie down on the grass, then I will not sleep for the next 14 years. If Lord Ramchandra has to sleep on grass bed, I should not sleep. That is the dedication of Lakshmana. So therefore, in 14 years of exile of Lord Ramchandra, Lakshmana never slept. Sometimes we perform Ekadasi Vrata, not to sleep one night, right? Very difficult. But he did not sleep for 14 years. That is called uninterrupted, continuous devotional service. But still, his intention was doubted. Sometimes we get discouraged that people doubt our intentions. So that comes from since time immemorial. Whenever you do some service, there will be doubts. If you want to be doubtless, don't do anything. Then you are nice. People don't like to be criticized. So if you don't want to be criticized, don't do anything. So when you do things, you will be criticized. And there is a slogan, in order to create enemy, you don't have to fight. When you become famous, and when you become glorious by your different achievements, naturally there will be enemies. So in this world you don't have to try to create enemies. They are naturally born. So don't be discouraged by this kind of thing. Prabhupada said, when, as long as you are in service, there will be criticism. So Lakshmana was criticized. Not criticized, he was doubted. Why? When Lord Ramchandra was sleeping with Sita Devi, and because Lakshmana took a vow not to sleep, that's why he used to guard Ramchandra with a bow and arrow. So Guha saw that. He said, Lakshmana, he is with the arrow, means he will kill Ram, because he is sleeping now, because if Rama is awake, he cannot kill him. So now is the good time to kill Ram. So Lakshmana wants to kill Ram and take away Sita, and later on he will enjoy Ayodhya. Guha started thinking like that. You know that this is called speculation. Without knowing, when you start thinking, that is called speculation. So Guha, what did he do? Oh, you want to kill Ram? I will not spare you also. So Ramchandra is sleeping, and around Ramchandra's room, Lakshmana is moving, and behind Lakshmana, Guha is also moving with his bow and arrow, ready to kill Lakshmana. Then Guha's soldiers, he started thinking that Guha is a devotee of Ram, and how come Guha is moving with bow and arrow to kill them? So must be he has some intention, bad intentions. So what the soldiers started doing? They also started moving with bow and arrow. So see, this is called speculation and doubt. So everybody had good intention. Lakshmana has a very sincere intention to protect Ram, but he was doubted. So this world is the world of doubts. So don't be discouraged while you perform devotional service. Prabhupada said, I was always discouraged by my god brothers, but I never gave up. The way Prabhupada was criticized, I think any of us will not continue. So discouragement, criticism, doubts are the natural elements when you perform devotional service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So you should learn from the character of Lakshmana. Even though he was sincerely trying to protect Krishna, people doubted that he will kill Ram. So then Lakshmana could handle everything what Ramchandra said, although very difficult sometimes. But one thing he could not handle. When Ramchandra told Lakshmana to take Sita to the forest and give Sita Devi in the custody of Valmiki Muni, so that time Lakshmana could not handle it. He said, it's very, very difficult for me. So, but he cannot protest because younger brother. That is a custom. So generally, younger brother does not protest the opinion of the elder brother. So that time he took a vow, from next incarnation, no more younger brother. So that's why when Ramchandra came as Krishna, then Lakshmana came as Balaram, as elder brother. Although he is elder brother, he serves Krishna as a servant. There are many pastimes. Third, they jump together, kick each other together. So they do all these things together, forgetting that who is elder, who is younger. So in that way, Balaram also served Krishna in the mood of a friend. Then he also served Krishna in the mood of a father. And that is natural. When you become elder brother always acts like a father. So he acted like a father. And when Krishna used to go to the forest, Mother Yashoda used to tell Balaram, you always protect Krishna. So in that mood, Lord Balaram used to serve Krishna in the mood of a father. So these are four are okay. But how Balaram can serve Krishna in conjugal mood? Because in order to serve Krishna in conjugal mood, you have to have gopi bhav and you have to have gopi deha, means body of a gopi. So Balarama is in a male form. So how we can serve Krishna in conjugal male? So therefore Balarama manifests himself as Ananga Manjari, as a sister of Srimati Radharani, and serve Krishna in the mood of conjugal male. So in this way, Balarama serves Krishna. That's why he is called servitor godhead. And what is the other difference between Krishna and Balarama? Difference in color. But in Vrindavan, you sometimes you see that Balarama has a color of Krishna also, black Balarama. Have you seen that? So why? If Krishna is white, Balarama is white, then how he becomes black? Just like when Krishna remembers Radharani, completely engrossed in the thinking of Radharani, he changes color. So he becomes golden and becomes Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So in the same way, when Balarama is completely absorbed in the thought of Krishna, that time Balaram's color changes and he becomes black like Krishna. That's why Balarama, although he is having fair complexion, but he changes his color. And sometimes Balarama wants to become like Krishna. One time Balarama told Krishna, I want to become like you. He said, okay, no problem. So generally Balarama wears blue garments because that gives the remembrance of Krishna. Today is the blue colored day, right? Balarama's day. Why he does that? Not to show to others, because that color helps him to remember Krishna. That's why he wears blue color. So that day he said, okay, we'll exchange everything. So he took the flute of Krishna, he took the garments of Krishna, he took the peacock feather of Krishna and moving around. And you know that when Krishna was in Gokul, Mahavan, Kamsa used to send demons every day. And you all know that when Krishna is in the forest, that time there was no hand watch to see the time. And some acharyas explained that when Kamsa used to send demon in the morning, Krishna used to kill that demon and that was the breakfast time. So in that way, Kamsa helped Krishna to determine time also. That is the unique nature of Krishna's pastime. So then in the afternoon, Kamsa used to send another demon, that is lunch time. And in the afternoon, in the evening time, Kamsa used to send another demon. And by killing that demon, that is the time to go back. So in that way, Kamsa was acting like the watch of Krishna. So when Krishna was moving around, Balarama, and Kamsa used to send demons. And Kamsa used to give a description how Krishna looks like. So on that day, Kesi demon came, Kesi. So he thought that moving around as Krishna is very nice, but he didn't know what he'll get. So Kesi got the news that Krishna looks like that, and that day Balarama was looking like that. And Kesi came and kicked Balarama, and Balarama was, the way he kicked is just thrown far distance, and he was having a lot of pain. It's a pastime though. And he was having breathing problem, Balarama. And he came back to his house and said, Krishna, no, I don't want to become Krishna. So please take back your all garments. You deal with all these things. So in that way, sometimes Balarama also acts like Krishna, although it's some bad experience. So in that way, although Balarama is fair in complexion, he changes the color. So now, Balarama's service is very, very unique, we explained. How Krishna from his child, not childhood, since his birth, Balaram is serving Krishna. Our acharyas are explaining that Devaki had 6 sons before Balaram appeared. And these 6 sons were killed by Kamsa. And these 6 sons of Devaki represent 6 anarthas. Kam, Krodh, Lobh, Moho, Mod, Mashirya. Lust, anger, greed, pride, envy, illusion. So these 6 anarthas are killed. And that time Balaram appeared into the heart of Devaki. And that is the message, that in order to attract the mercy of the spiritual master, our heart has to be pure. So generally, Balaram helps us to clean our heart. So Balaram came and made the heart of Devaki suitable so that Krishna can appear. Then Balaram was transported from the heart of Devaki to the heart of Rohiṇī. Because he was transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohiṇī, that's why his name is Sankarsan. And there is a trick also. Because Kamsa got the message from the sky that Devaki's 8th son will kill. So 7th son has the miscarriage. So then next one is 8th or 7th. Kamsa was confused. So Krishna wanted to confuse Kamsa also. And Krishna was born. As soon as Krishna was born, Krishna was having 400 form. Then he became 200 baby Krishna. And Krishna told Vasudev, please take me from the prison house to the house of Nanda Maharaj in Gokul. And it was dark midnight. Krishna appeared at midnight. Balaram appeared noontime. That's why Guru is more merciful than the Lord. For Balaram, fasting is till noon. For Krishna, fasting till midnight. So, Balaram was also eager to serve when Krishna was transported from the prison house to the house of Nanda Maharaj. On that day, there was heavy rain. Heavy rain. So I was hearing beautiful explanation why on that day of Krishna's appearance, at that night, there was heavy rain. There are many reasons given by the acharyas, but I will try to give 5 reasons why there was rain on that day. First, the rain, first reason why rain was there, the cloud was in ecstasy on that day. Why ecstasy? The cloud thought there are unlimited colors in the universe. But my Lord Krishna has appeared taking the color of me, the cloud was thinking. And he was in ecstasy. And out of ecstasy, when ecstasy comes, what happens? Tears flow from the eyes. So the cloud started shedding tears. And that's why there was rain. And although the cloud was in ecstasy, he was thinking that my Lord has appeared, I should offer something to the Lord. Then this is different, the second explanation. He said, what can I offer? But he remembered, Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita, patrang puspang phalang toyang jome bhaktar pajachati. He said, if you can offer water also, I am very happy. if it is offered with devotion. So cloud thought, I can offer unlimited water. So let me offer water with love. So that's why there was heavy rain. That was second reason. Third reason is that day Nanda Maharaj, not Nanda Maharaj, Vasudev was in a mission. And secretly he was trying to take Krishna from Mathura to Gokul. So it is said, generally people are there on the street, generally Jogamaya has arranged that on the all those guards in the prison were sleeping. But in order to make the road also peaceful and nobody will be there, the only way you can do is having rain. If there is heavy rain, then nobody will be outside. So in order to help Vasudev, there was heavy rain so that nobody will see that Krishna is transported from Mathura to Gokul. That was the what reason it is, this fourth, third one. Fourth, that ocean is known as the father of Lakshmi, right? The ocean become very jubilant that Krishna has appeared. And Krishna is the son-in-law of ocean. So the father-in-law thought, what I'll offer to my lord, to my son-in-law. Then what he did? He became cloud. And that cloud went to the Mathura area and started shedding water. And in that way, that father-in-law also offered the gift to his son-in-law. So in this way, our acharyas are explaining different reasons why there was heavy rains. There are many reasons also. But when there was rain, there is another difficulty also, that if there is heavy rain, one, there are so many advantages and so many love, so much love was going on. But Balarama was thinking that if such a heavy rain, then Krishna will be drenched with the rain water. So that time Balarama was acting like umbrella and he manifested himself as Anantasesh. So since the time of Krishna's appearing in the womb, then he took birth till the end of Krishna's pastime, Balarama was there all the time to serve Krishna. That's why Balarama is so glorious. It is also said that Balarama destroys our anartha in our heart. So Krishna killed a lot of demons. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained different demons represent different anarthas. Balarama also killed different demons. So one demon was, tell one of the demon's name, what Balarama killed, what demon? Dhenukasur. Dhenukasur means ass, means demon. Not demon, donkey. So donkey means no brain. So Dhenukasur represents ignorance. So Balarama killed Dhenukasur, and by this pastime he is exhibiting that our heart is also full of ignorance. So by killing Dhenukasur, we learn that in order to destroy the ignorance in our heart, so Balarama has to manifest in our heart. So in that way, all our ignorance will be destroyed. He killed another demon. His name was Pralambasur. Palambasur came as a cowherd boy. Balaram recognized that and killed him. And Palambasur represents gross lusty desire and subtle lusty desires. Gross lusty desires means desire for sex life, and subtle lusty desire means desire for profit, adoration and distinction. Both are lusty desires. Generally, by giving up sex life externally doesn't mean we are free from lust. That is easy to give up. Jiva Goswami says, giving up sex desire, although difficult, but it's not so difficult. Although Prabhupada said, one Subhaka Maharaj asked Prabhupada, when I can be free from sex desire? Prabhupada said, never. And he was very discouraged. He was not happy with the answer of Prabhupada. He said, I joined the movement because of that, and Prabhupada is telling like this, he was not happy. So, after a few days again, he was with the morning walk with Srila Prabhupada, and Maharaj asked, Prabhupada, how I can be free? Prabhupada said, Govinda Ichha. When the Lord will desire, that day you can be free from that desire. But controlling, managing that desire is not so difficult according to our previous acharyas. Because that is a fundamental thing. As long as you have sex desire, Prabhupada said, you cannot understand what is the spiritual world. Ecstasy of the spiritual world can manifest when you are free from sex desire. Therefore it is said, when you are free from sex desire, you are 50% liberated. Very important. Sex desire and releasing Krishna consciousness cannot go together. Very, very important. But that is gross. But according to Bhagavad Gita, this sex desire also subtle, because sex desire reside not only our senses, it is in our mind, it is in our intelligence. Everywhere, just like Paramatma is all pervading in this world, sex is also all pervading. That's why it is called Maithunaga, the ether is searched with sex desire, everywhere. So it's a world of sex life, Prabhupada has explained. Still, that is possible to manage. But to give up the desire of profit, adoration and distinction, that subtle desire is impossible to give up. That's why it is said, Jaro Potistha Sukarara Vistha. That's why our acharyas are very heavy on that. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, the desire to have prestige and follower like that, that is like a stool. And he also graphically explained what kind of stool. Sukarara Vistha, the stool of the hog. And because Gaudiya Vaishnavas are very interested to go deep of each sloka, no? So I was hearing a lecture from Radhanath Maharaj and he was explaining this sloka. And he was telling that why hog stool has been mentioned, why not other stool? So generally other animals, they eat food and pass stool. But hogs, they eat stool and pass stool. Means such a horrible stool they have. So that's why Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur has used this. Jaro Potistha Sukarara Vistha. And Pralambasur represents that. And Balaram can easily kill that. So today is a very auspicious day for us to take shelter of that Balaram. Prabhupada also said, I can kick Maya. Spiritual master has that potency. So Balaram is the original spiritual master. For him, taking care of all these things is very, very easy, provided we take shelter. We have to give the opportunity to Balaram so that he can do his job. And how that is possible? Allowing Balaram to destroy our subtle and gross sex desire? Surrender. Surrender is the way, because that is the only way we can get the mercy of the spiritual master. So Balaram is very simple-hearted person and he easily becomes angry. That is the nature of Balaram. Because he is expanding himself as Narayan expanding himself as Vasudev, Sankarsan, Aniruddha, Pradyumna. Everything is manifested from him and including Anantasesh. So therefore, Balaram becomes very angry. But when Krishna sees, then he immediately becomes peaceful. So Balaram is expert in clubs. So he was the teacher of both Bhima and Duryodhana. Although Duryodhana was demon, but Duryodhana was more favorite student than Bhima. Why? I was hearing that Duryodhana was very meticulous, very artistic. He knew the art of fighting with the club better than Bhima. Bhima was little gross, means hit and fight and kill like that. But Duryodhana was very artistic, meticulous in the art. That's why Balaram had some weakness towards Duryodhana. But Duryodhana has to be killed. And he got the kavaja from his mother. The shield is there, he cannot be killed. Because his body became like thunderbolt. But one section of the body was weak, that is the thigh. And according to the principle of the fight of the club, you cannot hit below the waist. But Krishna told Bhima, kill him, but how he can kill? Because he cannot be killed. Then he said, hit on the thigh, hit on the thigh. Bhima said, how can I hit on the thighs against the principle of dharma? He said, I am telling, hit there, hit there. So Duryodhana was hit at the thigh and he was killed. Krishna was happy. Bhima was not so happy, but okay. But Balaram was extremely angry to hit on the thigh of Duryodhana. You are coward. He was very angry. Then when Krishna told Balaram, wait, I have told him to do that. So what to do? When Krishna said, I have told, then Balaram became pacified. So that is the mood of Balaram. Although he is too angry, but for Krishna, he is very peaceful. Whatever Krishna sees, he follows. That's the quality of Guru. Guru follows the instruction of the Supreme Personality of God. So Arjuna kidnapped Subhadra. Arjuna came as a sadhu. So kidnapping means you have to be a sadhu, right? Very bad. That's why people don't trust this sadhu dress. Ravana. So Ravana came to kidnap Sita. What dress he used? Abhisanyasi. Sadhu. So that's why so many hypocrites, sannyasis are there now in Kali Yuga? Because they are the parampara of Ravana. Ravana parampara. But Arjuna, although he came like that, but it was with good intention, because Krishna told. Because Krishna wants to have fun. So Krishna told that Balaram will not agree. Because Subhadra is very dear to Balaram. So what happens then? Krishna, that Arjuna came as a monk, as a sadhu. And Balaram has a lot of respect for the sadhus. So he told Subhadra, please serve him. But Subhadra understood who is he, and Arjuna kidnapped Subhadra by the plan. Plan was devised by Krishna. So Balaram became very angry and he was following Arjuna to kill him. Then Krishna stopped Balaram. He said, I did that. I made that arrangement. Don't be so angry. He said, okay, you should have told me before. So Balaram became pacified. So this is the interaction between Krishna and Balaram. So I'll tell one more pastime to finish. So generally, Krishna Balaram is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. From them everything happens in this creation. and see the unique nature of Krishna Balaram. So Mother Yashoda bound Krishna with the rope. It's in all this pastime. So Krishna generally, when he gets harassed from his mother, he takes shelter of Balaram and Rohini. So Krishna does a lot of naughty things in the house, but Mother Yashoda cannot discipline Krishna the way she wants. Obstacles are Rohini and Balaram. So Mother Yashoda thinking, because I have given some heavy punishment to Krishna, and he is waiting for that day when Balaram and Rohini will not be there. On Dambandhan Lila day, that day, Balaram and Rohini were not there. And that was the appearance day of Balaram. Some other festival was there. So that day, Balaram was not there, Rohini was not there in the house. So Mother Yashoda thought, today is the best day. So she wanted to punish Krishna. And Krishna was bound because nobody was there to help him. Helpless. He was heavily bound, tight. And it's very difficult for Krishna to stay at one place because he always moves around. So that time, in the afternoon time, Balaram came. And as soon as Balaram came, he said, "My dear brother, in your presence, see the injustice." He started complaining, loudly complaining, so that Mother Yashoda can hear. So he complained to Balaram, and Balaram became very angry. "Who did that? Who did that?" But Krishna never told, Mother Yashoda did, okay? So Krishna said, "So much injustice in this house, please help me." He said, "Okay. I got it. Who did that? Who is very angry, Balaram?" And when Balaram was shouting, screaming, then Mother Yashoda said, "I have done it. I have done this. You have any problem with that?" Then Balaram started giving lecture. He said, "You don't know who is Krishna. He is the supreme personality of Godhead. He is the cause of all causes. He is the source of all incarnations. He is the source of everything. Aham sarvasya prabhava." He started giving Bhagavad Gita lecture. So when Mother Yashoda heard that lecture, he said, "Oh, really? Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead, right? Okay, then who are you?" "So you don't know who am I? I am Balaram, I am Sankarsan, I am Anantasis, I am this and that." And he started giving his identity. He said, "Oh, so the Lord has no other place. All the Lords have to come in my house already, right?" So then she took a stick, and by seeing the stick, Balaram ran away and told Krishna, "I cannot help you. I told you, don't do all these things in front of Mother Yashoda. You don't do this, all these things." So Krishna Balaram, who are the supreme personality of Godheads, by seeing the stick of Mother Yashoda, they are running in fear. That shows that love is the supermost aspect in our whole existence. That's why Krishna controls everything, but he is controlled by the love of the Vrajavasis. Therefore, Krishna Balaram cannot leave Vrindavan. That's why Krishna manifests himself according to the desire of different devotees. All other planets have been created to fulfill the desire of living entities. But Vrindavan is created to fulfill the desire of Krishna. That's why Vrindavan is home of Krishna. So that is the topmost planet. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said, "Aradya Bhagavan Brajeshatanaya Taddhama Vrindavanam." So therefore our worshipable Lord is Krishna, not Krishna in Mathura, not Krishna in Dwaraka. Krishna who is born from Mother Yashoda. And Balaram one day told Krishna, "Krishna, See, I am fair complexion. Nanda Maharaj also fair. Mother Yashoda also not black like you. But you, why you have this kind of color? You know why? I never told you before because you will be discouraged. But I am telling you today the secret. Actually, you don't belong to this family, okay? Mother Yashoda brought you from somewhere else. As soon as, it was, Balarama was joking. But as soon as he heard that, he started crying. Because Krishna cannot think that there can be anybody than Mother Yashoda as his mother. That is Vrindavan. So I'll tell another pastime to finish it, sorry. Because I have so many things to say. After killing Kamsa, so Krishna Balaram went to Vasudev and Devaki to free them from the prison. Nanda Maharaj also came to Mathura and Krishna Balaram told that we will go and come back. But the whole night passed. Krishna never came back, Balaram never came back and he was in anxiety. So in the morning Krishna Balaram came back. Said, why? It was so late. He said, what to do? We are spending time with Devaki, Vasudev, my mother and father. And Nanda Maharaj was in anxiety. Because Nanda Maharaj knows that Krishna is the son of Vasudev. So then he said, they are telling so many things. And then Nanda Maharaj was thinking, if Vasudev has told him or not. He said, what he told? Everything. He said, he told this, he told this. And he also told that I am his son. As soon as Nanda Maharaj heard that, he was shaking. And he said, you believe that? Krishna said, how can I believe that I am son of Vasudev and Devaki? I cannot believe that. Because I know I am your son. I am the son of Mother Yashoda. Even Vasudev Devaki say that, I don't believe. And when Nanda Maharaj heard that, he was very much satisfied. So in that way, Krishna is exhibiting that he cannot be the son of anybody else other than Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda. That is the mood of Vrindavan. So therefore, Krishna Balaram in Vrindavan is topmost, although they have lot of pastimes in Mathura and Dwaraka, and time is also not there. I had a desire to speak some pastimes from Dwaraka also. But it's a very wonderful day, and we should take the mercy of Balaram by taking his shelter and pray. Prabhupada said, we pray to Balaram for spiritual strength. So, by taking shelter at his lotus feet, by praying to his lotus feet, we get the spiritual strength. With that spiritual strength, we can cross over the nations of this material world and go back to the spiritual world. That can be our sincere prayer. Bhagavan Sri Balaram ki, Balaram Jayanti Mahamahotsav ki, Appearance Day celebration of Balaram ki, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol.